the Overwatch beta. Other than running it to set my video settings and make sure everything worked, I have not played this game. I have barely watched videos. I've seen a bunch of the introduction to the characters, but I've not watched a single stream. I've barely paid attention to the other trailers. I just went, ooh, team-based shooter. Made by Blizzard. I'm interested. I want to play. So here we go. I am eating some pepperoncino. Hope I'm pronouncing that right. Chips. Because I totally have the munchies. And this is taking a while. I don't remember doing that before. Maybe the server's down and I didn't check. There we go. Lovely. So, I turned my settings up a little higher than it set them to at default. My system's pretty good. And I tend to put up with a little bit of jitteriness sometimes. It depends. It's a shooter, so I might put it down lower. But I want to see what it looks like. And then I'll back off from there. This is a beta, though, so maybe I'll have to go down so it'll be smooth. We'll see. So I haven't done the training. I haven't done anything. Let's take a look at Hero Gallery. So while we're doing this, I want to talk about myself. I've played a lot of shooters. I played probably the first true shooter I played was Doom. And I remember back in the days of us trading discs or downloading from CompuServe that I got the Doom Shareware version. Actually, I think my friend got like a leaked version of it before there was even a Shareware one where nothing was animated and you could walk around and see the imps and monsters standing there. Like that's how long I've been interested in shooters. I played back when we didn't use mouse and keyboard. We just used the keyboard because you couldn't look up. Why would you bother? And so I remember switching to mouse keyboard a long, long time ago. I went through, I played Counter-Strike. I loved Tribes. I adored Tribes 2. Not so much a fan of the next. Tribes Ascend is fun. Loki's Minion CTF, going back to the Quake days, is probably where I got into team-based gaming. Never really played competitively. I joined a clan when I played Battlefield 1942, which I also played just tons and tons of hours of. But we were not very good. And got just completely creamed by people who had just run drills on where to aim in the sky and things like that that bothered me about competitive play. And I just kind of soured on it and just kept playing for fun. My team-based shooter since then has been Team Fortress 2. I'm a huge fan. I have my whatever the badge is that signifies when you get it. Mine is 5 a.m. on the first day you could have possibly pre-ordered Team Fortress 2. I just had to wait that long to get money into my account or something. I don't think I had a credit card at the time. I don't really now. Okay. Well, this doesn't really tell me what they do. Okay, so this is all the stuff you can unlock. Well, I guess I can. Can I just. Now, if I can. If I could left and right arrow through here, or. That would be great. In case Blizzard watches. If I just go from this to hit a button, that would then go to here. Right? Like, even if, and you could even do like a, I would rotate and they would be standing over on the right. And then you do it again and you'd look back to the left, and instead of this person, it would be whoever was next. And just left and right would choose back and forth in that list, and you would just look one way or the other. Cool. I love that design. I have no idea which of these characters I'm going to want to play. In Team Fortress, my main is Demo Man, actually. I like playing offensive tricks, I guess. I'm not a super great shot, so I'm not a good sniper, exactly. So the explosions help. But I like to be able to move around. The Soldier, I'm okay with at Soldier, but I don't really play it that often. I just find it a little too basic, and I'm better at Demo. I just would prefer to play Demo if I'm going to play that kind of class. And I play a little bit of Engineer, which is a lot of just building. But mostly Demo Man. So I don't know what... pardon me. Don't know what I'm going to play here. Let's take a look at this. That is pretty rad. But they have those legs on the bottom. I do remember seeing some of this guy's stuff and kind of how he worked, at least back then, but I didn't bother remembering any of this because being in beta, or at the time alpha, everything was subject to change, so I figured, who cares? Just I'll look at it when it shows up. That's pretty awesome. Get some body diversity there. Mercy. It's a... poses. I mean, I get it, but I kind of like the Neil Gaiman concept of angels, where they're way more androgynous. Like, the whole idea of sex is human, right? Like, male and female. That's a human thing that quote-unquote God specifically did. So angels should be above that. There's no male and female angels. Angels are just angels. So they should kind of look like, well, you can't tell. They should look like anime characters. So way more androgynous is what I'm saying. And that gets rid of the problem of this butt posture thing here. And you can still keep, I mean, that face is great. It's androgynous enough face. I love the hair. Halo helmet thing is neat. Just get rid of the, like, you know, make maybe a little more military of a chest, a little broader chest. Make it so it could be a male muscular chest. Or a woman. Or armor. Or whatever. Get rid of this ridiculousness. Anyway, I digress. Mm-hmm. Pharaoh, neat. I like that. I tend to avoid playing characters that are like cool, unless I really like the way they play, because they tend to be the ones that, I don't know, inexperienced players go for and just generally get a bad name, and I feel bad playing it. But at the same time, maybe he'll end up being super fun to play and I'll want to play it. I don't tend to want to play slow. My reflexes are still pretty good. So if these guys are slower, I'd probably rather not. Hooray! An old guy. Says the old guy. Now, Symmetra. I don't know what any of that means. Here we go. Ah, the engineer. I might give him a try. We've got Tracer. I've seen her from a bunch of it. She seems pretty cool. Totally dig this look. See, it's not that being feminine's not allowed, especially when you're a human. And she's younger. cute. It's nice. Widowmaker. I shoot people, but I do it and look good at the same time. I work on contract. I don't care if it's a contract to kill or a contract for a modeling gig. I come ready for either. This is... But at the same time, you know, she's allowed to look good at her job if that's what she wants. Winston, interesting. Saria. Okay, that's rad. That is also cool. I could be tempted to play that if it's neat. All right, let's do some training. Tutorial. Because I haven't played a bit. I did remap my keys. Thanks to playing Tribes, I'm an ESDF player. The key remapping was pretty good. Here we go.
This is Athena. I will be guiding you through the Overwatch training program. Let's begin. First, look up at the dropship above you. Thank you. We'll need some assistance for the next part of the program. Now, where is she?
Hiya! Tracer here!
Now, use your controls to watch Tracer as she moves through the room.
Over here!
Excellent. Now watch Tracer as she moves over to launch control. Watch Tracer one more time, then we can continue.
So this is good. I mean...
Up here!
Good.
I like when it starts at the basics, actually.
You can move forwards and backwards in the direction you're looking. In addition, you can move left and right. Let's put those skills to use. Please follow Tracer as she moves around the hangar. Continue following Tracer. Now follow Tracer to the weapons bay. I think you have the hang of it. You can jump over small obstacles. Jump up and follow Tracer to the target range. Welcome to the target range. Move to the highlighted area.
We don't want to see this.
Let's begin combat training. First, let me begin to activate your heads-up display. Your portrait is displayed in the lower left corner of your screen. That's you, Soldier 76.
Sure
Next
is.
To it is your current health. If it reaches zero, you die. I would recommend avoiding that eventuality. Your primary weapon is your heavy pulse rifle. Let me get you something to shoot at. You aim through the crosshairs in the middle of your screen. Moving over your target, then fire. Nicely done. You can also strike targets near you with a melee attack. Move next to the target, aim, then strike it with your rifle. Not all targets will be as easy to hit as this one. I am deploying some mobile training bots for you to destroy. Note the red outline around the robots. All enemies will be marked in this manner. Damaging an enemy will display their current health above their head.
Okay, now do headshots matter?
Most weapons fire a limited amount of ammo before they need to be.
I think they do.
Your current status is displayed here, in the bottom right of the screen. If you run out of ammo, you will automatically reload. You can also manually reload. There is one vault remaining. Great work. That covers the basics of your weapon. The next phase of the training program will focus on your abilities. Let's begin with sprint. Good. In addition to sprint, you also have the ability to heal yourself with biotic field. To demonstrate it, I need to damage you slightly. Now, deploy a biotic field.
What's that? Oh, press. Okay, that means I gotta set that. So let's go set that. Which one is that? That is key bindings. Ability one.
Go ahead. Activate a biotic field.
Is it left shift or right button? No?
You can heal yourself with a biotic field.
Uh-huh. I got Q, I got Y.
Go ahead. Activate a biotic field.
Left shift, right button.
You can heal yourself with a biotic field.
Oh no, that's left button, right button, not right click. Okay, so that is empty. Ability 2. So I have to set that to...
You can heal yourself with a biotic field. Stand within the glowing area to heal.
There we go.
Note that you have to wait a short time before using that ability again. This cooldown time is displayed over the ability icon. In addition to your rifle's standard mode of fire, it is also equipped with helix rockets. You can launch a volley of rockets in the direction you're aiming. The rockets explode on contact. I have prepared a set of targets for you. Fire your helix rockets at the targets. Note how the helix rockets damage targets near the point of impact. Finally, let me explain tactical visor. Activating your tactical visor is your ultimate ability. These powerful abilities can change the course of a game. You must fully charge your ultimate ability before you can use it. Your current charge level is displayed here, at the bottom of your screen. You charge your ultimate ability by dealing or taking damage.
And stay down.
Your ultimate is 50% charged. Your ultimate is almost fully charged. Your tactical visor is charged. Your tactical visor will optimize your shots so that they always strike your target. Now, activate your tactical visor and open fire.
I've got you in my sights.
All targets
destroyed. You didn't
make
the cut.
Nice work, Soldier 76.
Well, what if I'm already a decent shot?
For the final phase of the training,
I mean, I guess
program,
if they're moving,
we'll go
dodging.
Over capturing objectives. Your current objective is indicated with a directional marker, labeled A. Head through the open door and proceed to the objective.
More peanut butter and a chocolate chip cookie. Whose choice is that? That's who I want to play.
The objective is marked with a bright outline on the ground. To capture,
take that objective A.
While you are within the area, you make progress towards capturing the objective.
Got it.
Your current progress is displayed here on your screen.
Securing.
If there are enemies in the area with you, capture progress is paused.
I'm on fire.
There are times when you will want to switch heroes during a match. Bring up the hero select screen to view all available characters. Let's try switching to Tracer. Select Tracer from the list of heroes below. When you have a hero selected, you can view details about them by pressing the information button.
To your previous location and health. Love it. Okay, so she is the teleporting scout character who can heal by going, oh crap, that was a mistake, and backing up. So you can kind of look around a corner, get shot, and as long as you're alive, undo that. Neat.
Now confirm your selection by pressing the continue button. Well done. You have completed your basic combat training. You can now try a practice match against AI, replay the tutorial, or face off against other players.
Okay. So who do we have here? Oh, okay, interesting. This is the rocket launching soldier. Okay. Self sentry, sniper, alpine pass. Drive and detonate an exploding tire. Okay, once I'm done these chips, I'll stop. I'll start talking more. Too good. Okay. Concussion mind, throat triggered. Well, I could be that guy. May, what do you do? May slows and freezes enemies, making them vulnerable to attack. So, cryo freeze, become invulnerable and heal yourself. Ice wall, create a wall in front of you. Endothermic blaster, short range spray that freezes on the long range. Shoots and freezes and sets up walls. Neat. So his ultimate is molten core. So we got, let's look at rivet gun, slow firing, and long range weapon, short but powerful. So, single rivet or basically a shotgun. Also the forge hammer, swing to improve your turret or damage an enemy. That's 1 and 2. Scrap collector, collect scrap to gain resources. So you use those resources on those, okay. Iron pack, build a turret. Okay. On an even notice, offense, defense, tank, support. Okay. So we got tank. So I don't normally play games that split this much into each class does each thing. Not gonna play a sniper. Okay, so what do the tank classes look like? I do tank in Warcraft. I expect this is going to require me to know the game a little better. And in Team Fortress 2, I do complain quite a bit when new players take one of the classes that really require you to know the game to play well, like Sniper or Spy. Especially Spy. You're not going to play Spy until you know at least a couple of the other classes fairly well. You're not going to play Spy very well at all. Support. Well, what's Lucio do? Difficulty 3. Maybe I won't do a difficulty 3 character right off the bat. Oh, mercy. Oh, well, I could just play medic and try and heal people to know what they're doing and watch them for a while. That is a thing I like people to do in Team Fortress. Find shields, so she's pre-damaging, which again would be good. I could keep the shield up and then stay out of trouble. Oh, I like that. Deploy a small turret that damages and slows enemies. Difficulty 1. Okay, Symmetra. I think I might play Symmetra. Oh, but this guy's really cool. Or this thing. Person. Offensive support. Oh, difficulty 3, though. Heal allies and cripple enemies. Stamina with the orbit disc takes increased damage. He has low health and mobility, but transcendence makes him briefly invulnerable. Nah, I don't like slow. I think I'm gonna try out Symmetra.
The true enemy of humanity is disorder.
Oh, okay, so I can bring this up anytime with F1. Okay, so because there are no allies, I can't give this to anybody. So I've got this, which is the build. That is slow.
You are trapped in your own mind.
This is my give shields, right? Yeah. So what is that again? Oh yeah.
Teleporter online. We move swiftly.
Wait, what? Deploys a teleporter connection to the spawn room. How?
Turret deployed.
That's not bad.
Sentry turret placed. You were not meant for greatness.
Wait, what?
Defenses in place.
Hold on. Oh, just the more I have, the slower it recharges?
Sentry deployed. A pattern develops. Turret deployed.
Oh, was that the limit? 1, 2, 3, 4, 6? Hold on. Yes. Okay, so 6 is the limit. Interesting. Okay. And then,
the balance shifts in my favor.
It's A again. Give shields to an ally. So I need an ally. Sharp beam weapon with increasing damage hold.
Just as expected.
It does hit. Oh, and it locks on. Got it.
Shield engaged. You are all shielded. Everything in its place. Why do you struggle against your fate?
Hmm.
turret in place.
Not all that mobile. Must be in the spawn room. Okay.
A pattern develops.
I'll be watching over you.
Okay, so... Resurrect revives a dead teammate. Left shift fly towards an ally. Hold to heal an ally or hold to increase. So left click heal, right click increase the damage. I'm guessing there's no overheal, so it's mostly right click.
Damage increased. Damage boost engaged. Patching you up. Let's get you back out, sir. Healing stream engaged.
So blue damage, yellow healing.
Heroes never die.
Oh, it's everybody. Okay. Still not that mobile, so a lot of actual thinking about moving around. All right. Oh, let's try out Zarya.
Together, we are strong.
We've got particle cannon, short linear beam. Short range, yeah. And then energy grenade launcher. So left shift, create a damage barrier around you, create a damage barrier on an ally. So it's just a shoot, shield. So it's difficulty 3. Passive damage block increases particle damage. Oh, neat. So how long does this last?
This is strength.
That's it.
Огонь по готовности!
All right, Winston, what do you got?
Imagination is the essence of discovery.
Sure. Depending on what essence means. Okay, so you get your Tesla cannon. It's an electrical frontal cone cannon. I like that I can see his... cone. All right, good. Everybody reloads. I like that. One of my big complaints in Team Fortress is that the heavy class, which already has so much going for it, never, ever has to stop to reload. I didn't mean to do that. So we got barrier projection is A, deployed protective energy dome. jump pack, leap forward in the air, landing on enemies. Oh, damn, nice. And then gain immense health, but you can only leap and punch. And leap is,
Barrier up. Excuse me for dropping in. Pardon me. This will protect us.
Landing, it's just landing on an enemy will damage. That did damage that guy, but what range we're talking about here? Wow, it is short range. Like, it's basically why can't I punch you range, right?
Now that's some applied science.
Oh, so that's dangerous. Kill cam. Yeah.
Further experimentation required.
Okay, so I don't have to switch to using my punch button.
I seem to have lost my temper. Natural selection. Survival of the fittest.
I guess compared to Team Fortress's, granted it takes two people to do 10 seconds of complete invulnerability or critskrieging of instant criticals. What you got, Roadhog? Short range, heal, pull. Rocket Hammer, Devastating Melee. I'm not a melee. I'm terrible at melee in these damn games, I think. Well, I mean, maybe they'll have changed it. What do you got? Fusion Cannons. Oh, so she drives a tank. She drives a mech. Jackson Overloads, Call Mech, just ultimate. Boosters fly in the direction you're facing. Let's try this one. I'm ready to win. Oh, never reload.
Eliminated.
Oh, but you barely move. Well, fine, I got it. What does A do? A is defense matrix, blocks projectiles in an area in front of you. Alright. Interesting.
I'm just getting warmed up.
Oh.
Nerf this!
That's a big explosion. I thought I was more than far enough away. Let's see how that works. Okay, so this is an interesting character that has all this mobility, but not one fire. I think I'd want to play this one. Alright, that's enough. Let's, how do I, exit, social agreement, leave game. Okay. Let's try a quick play.
Now entering King's Row.
Although I don't know if talking to you means that I can't talk to people. Let's play the tank that shoots. No idea what I'm doing here. This is interesting. Hey!
Traveling to Hanamura.
Okay. Traveling to Hanamura. I don't know what that means.
Prepare to attack.
No, I'm gonna play this one. Few offense, no support. Alright, I'll be support. Sure. Oh wait, no, I was the only tank. Somebody go tank or support. Okay.
I'm ready to win.
Attack commences in 30 seconds.
No one's beating my high scores.
Let's screw around and get ready to move.
Enemy turret over there!
Hey, I got one.
Enemy turret destroyed.
Healed up.
It's the only healing thing I can find. Those are downed teammates, right?
Mine! This is my boy!
Go, go, go! Fuck, what you doing, man?
The boy is mine! And he can't speak!
Check me out!
Objective A captured. Commence attack on objective B.
Enemy turret's not gonna bother us anymore.
Get the cover.
So I have to do this until I can call down another mech.
Justice reigns from above!
Is that good? I don't know. Where am I?
I'm back in the game.
Enemy turret destroyed.
No idea if that's how that's supposed to work.
Current detected. I'm taking the objective. Converge on me.
Hey, take the off.
Victory. Play of the game.
Loot box. Oh, Okay, so this is how it works. So you unlock, so we got here. Spray, the voice line, a skin. Do I get all of them? May, blaster. Sure, I don't know. Equip, whatever.
I am the strongest woman in the world.
Yep. Straw. I don't know what it means. Sure. Equip it. Yeah. I should be able to toggle. See, right here? I don't know. Spray, what you looking at? Sure. I'll try. Let's do it. What time is it? I gotta get ready for a board game night tonight. But that was cool. Searching for a game. Oh, also my dog needs to go outside. So let's just let this go.
Welcome to Hollywood. Prepare to attack.
Oops, I forgot I turned my microphone off. I'm going to just try to heal people. I'm going to go support. Just going to follow people around.
You are ready to do some damage. Your mother always hoped you'd follow in her footsteps.
She did? Funny, she never mentioned that to me. She knew what she liked.
Damage boost engaged.
Let's keep the skies clear together.
I do like that the selection screen, it doesn't force you to take a certain build, but it does mention, hey, you're short on certain things. I don't mind playing whatever it takes. I mean, there's going to be a thing I'm going to realize I'm going to be the most effective at some point.
Action!
I doubt it's going to be support.
Maintaining connection.
4, 3, 2, 1. Attack commencing. Capture objective A.
Keep an eye on your health and call for me if you need assistance. That doesn't hurt. I could use some assistance. You are ready to do some damage. Let's get you back out, sir. Needed.
Okay, that was cool.
Did something for the
pass into the iris.
Securing the objective.
Get moving!
You are ready to do some damage. Healing stream engaged.
The objective is mine. Be quick about
it. Damage amplified.
I am taking the objective. Join me.
Objective A is captured. Escort the payload.
I could use some assistance. Right beside you. You are ready to do some damage. We have secured the payload. Let's move. Of modern medicine.
Oh, there are the stats on the bottom. Offensive assists, okay. So 4-2 deaths. 4-4, 2 deaths, 3 players resurrected. I feel good about that.
Time to get my hands dirty. Armor over.
Payload warning. All together.
All systems
check
out.
Into the iris.
Well, I don't really know what happened there, but...
What is new? Damage increased. Heroes never die. Where does it hurt?
Okay, just murders me. Two swings.
A clean bill of health.
How's this work? Okay.
replace you.
Armor here!
60 seconds remaining.
Thank you. Damage increased. I'm under.
Well,
what is new?
What have we got? Nothing good. I'll keep playing this. We're gonna lose.
It's happening.
One he kept doing, which was area effect stun everybody and then area effect kill me. Okay, that's it. I'm gonna take a break. That was fun though, even the loss. I don't really enjoy support. Oh, I got another loot box though. Let's open it up. Victory pose, love it. Also, they are totally getting this stuff from Team Fortress All Heroes Victory Spray. I don't know what that is. Preview. Equip. I guess I. What?
Revenge takes only the one who seeks it.
Sure. No. No, I mean, sure. Right? Yeah. Tracy's cool. All right, that was fun. I'm going to play with my dog because he's awesome.